it's 4 o'clock and they're done, today wasn't the street, so.
We just.
And that's why it's on the website, that's why we put it in the newsletter, so everybody knows.
I see a lot of that driving the list.
And people call us and they say, yeah, what's my pickup date, you know, and we don't get a lot of complaints, so.
That's why you're really trying to focus in on what you're trying to.
Well, here's another thing, I mean, I've been throwing this stuff a lot. Why don't we bag them like St. Clair? Yeah, St. Clair bags all there. I was just saying, I mean, then you got, it's gotta be quicker to go around and chuck a few bags in the back of a truck than it is to go around. So you got the community doing a lot more to work, frees up your borough, because there are things, I'm not saying to do it, I'm just saying, think about it.
Like give out your like leaf bags.
I mean, I don't know.
Be in the line. Yeah, I love them. Do what you want, bro. I've lived in other areas that didn't have that, you had to bag it all, and it's much, much.
And a lot of.
Really great service.
A lot of the communities, like, so they have bag them and then they tell the residents where to take them, they don't give you information.
Yeah.
So it's easier for the residents, and they tell us that, to give them that service where you just break it out, it's there, they suck them up, and, you know, it's a service we try to give them. And then November starts the brush grinder program too, where people put out their brush and everything within 12 inches of diameter.
That's in November?
The whole month. And we follow the street sweeper schedule for that too. And so people put them out and then.
Tuesday.
That's nice. I got a big push on mine.
Most of these colleagues don't do that either.
That's a nice.
That's pretty.
We take.
Call your, I mean, treacherous.
Well, if we have a lot, we pull the street, we pull it, the brush grinder, it goes right there, it goes right in, it goes into the truck, then it goes down the truck tiers. And if it's usable, we put that as bottom padding of our playground, and then we get good mulch and we put it over, and that way we don't have to buy so much mulch, so.
So when's this brush grinding?
The whole month of November, and it follows the street sweeper schedule.
So Tuesday morning, so I missed mine, I put mine out Wednesday, so that's what I'm saying, that makes sense. Okay, so I put them out for the same day, put them right out on the street?
Right out on your curb and suck them right up.
The branches, right?
The branches, you can put them right at the end of your yard where you can see them, and that just started this month, so.
And they do the alley too, so I don't want to be, we'll come in the alleys, I don't worry about it.
Hi, why? That's good, that works for me.
Yeah, go ahead, I put mine.
I do too.
I'm not gonna sit there and go, oh shit.
Sometimes the weather and when you get home, it's real nice out at night.
I get all my neighbors' leaves anyway.
Yeah.
They got a break.
Old age is terrible for these springs, is that? That leaves you.
It's not one that I answered.
You don't see them?
That is not the answer I want to hear, Rich. Oh, okay, I was like, that is not the answer I want to hear. I tried to look it up on the e-code that you introduced me to, and I couldn't find anything on that. All I could find was like domesticated animals and undomesticated animals.
That really, if you get my leaves, I gotta rake them Monday night.
Yeah, I guess that's. I did mine Saturday. Nice day, I was cutting the grass, cleaning the yard up, and that's where I really. Of course, just leaving the back alley, kicking all over. Little data, bugs.
How you doing? Still kicking, right?
Yeah, I'd say the guy across the street from me is like all his little.
Three points of good news. 1, 2, 3. It's 1 point. 3 points. Oh, yeah, because the one wasn't officially counted, right?
More shopping, I mean, pressing comments.
Minor stuff, you know, time is any, right?
I was saying the three most.
The alley between, Harry Chestnut.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, because it was really.
And Liz, I'm asking, do you know about the overgrowth there?
I haven't had anybody call me about.
Three years ago. Hey, anything else?
Yeah. Elements.
No, mine's good right now.
No, you don't, but with it being that close?
Usually if there's overgrowth and scratching cars and whatever, they call me and I send them a letter, so I'll have a phone call.
Instead of calling you, they mentioned it to me while I was walking around.
They didn't tell you where. Well, I'll have to know where it is.
Yeah, is it an Elm resident or a Chestnut resident?
I don't know, I was on Chestnut, I mean, I was on Elm, sorry. I was on Elm, I guess it's the one that, yeah.
I probably won't.
Oh, really?
I know, like, my.
You're showing your age there, but I'm going.
My house, our alley, which I think it's mine.
Ooh, well, it could be on there, Gary Collins, up to 85. She always, she likes it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Would you like Joe and Roy and Lori to bring you guys in the AC over for a long?
Sure.
The previous decree of 2002 anticipated the next phase was going to be an obviously take all water, take all commerce scenario. That is going to change, which is made the water flow back up, no way, yes. And as a result, we're moving towards a more flow reduction model in the future. So as a result of that, it's going to be kind of a 2-year interim mini study. And they have most of that already for the stop phase, and we're trying to implement what they got us consistent previously in 2018. So under this decree now, which needs to be signed until the 15th of December, there's a phase from 2015 to 2017, where mainly the engineers are working with the managers and you guys are sort of doing a lot of cross-pollination with other municipalities now to do these sewage reduction studies. And do a report. And then in the meantime, and then at the same time, among those studies that you do, you have to do one demonstration project. That could be actually implemented any kind of sale ordinance or another kind of lateral testing ordinance. It could be an INI reduction project that you should give you some bang for the buck. And in that second, those studies will lead to really the bigger shoe dropping in the next round, which is 2018, which will be the next long time. That'll be the long term. Is that fairly summarized, Jeff?
I think it does, and I think we've already started looking at some areas where we could possibly get some reduction in INI as a demonstration project. That we've had some results from the feasibility study a few years ago. And I emailed out a map with a short memo to everybody last week that identified those few areas. So I want to look at some of our CCTV data and see if there's locations are still viable to do the maybe do a liner or maybe pipe posting or something to get that INI down. So, but I mean, I think it's a combination of things. I mean, looking at the low hanging fruit might be trying to get the INI out. For those main lines, and I think maybe this other stuff might be looking at the ordinance for the point of sale for the laterals being checked and inspected and replaced if necessary. Because, you know, I may have said this before, you know, we're going to have 1,000 feet of storm sewer on the street. We have more than 1,000 feet of laterals on the street because of the distance of the main line of the house.
Right.
You take that, there's more lateral pipe than there is main line.
Sure.
And they want to see that either as part of this demonstration, or it's predicted that certainly it's going to be come coming.
Can we do a CCTV, we camera those little pipes? How accurate a picture do we get?
You get a very good picture.
An ACBM pipe?
Oh, there's a whole rating system rating the defects in the pipe from 1 to 5, with 5 you can look at people's laterals, you can take the head of the camera and you can pan and tilt it and look up people's laterals.
Good, Mike.
So
that you can see really good.
If you're on the bottom, you see their trucks.
It's just like
I'm just wondering, like,
you can go online.
You know, we always talk about, you know, we're getting infiltration with other,
right?
You know, can they see? Oh, here it is, it's coming through this.
You may see some of it. It's always the study was looking at the interceptor pipe that's in the Glock and Run. I mean, you have a pipe that's in water, okay, and it's old pipe that's terracotta, probably has leaking joints. You're going to see that water infiltrating and pouring in it. So that might be the location where we don't have the lateral to do the liners. Okay, there's one area there back on the back side of New York Street that comes down in that valley behind A&H equipment. We did spot repairs on that sanitary sewer probably about 5 years ago. And, you know, that's terracotta pipe for the most part. We need to look at the videotape of that. That's a natural drainage area. When it rains, there might be water getting into that sanitary sewer.
Right.
So there's like, I'll call it low hanging fruit. We just need to make sure that
that's what I'm wondering. Yeah, we have a sanitary sewer pipe. And if we're going to start, well, we're not. It's not if we are. When everybody starts getting charged for how much we put into it, or you know, how we keep the fresh water out, so we're only being charged for
the sewage. That's right. So I think we look at those now. We have some of the data from the flood water and some of the key points. We look at those areas, we put the liners in it, reduce the INI, go put the flood waters back in there, and see what the reduction is.
And we're lining
now. We're lining now, right? We're doing liners.
What's our contract?
I want to say 73,000.
So we are lining.
All right. You know, we're spending money to do a liner.
I've heard that for 6 years.
But don't worry, because we don't really need to do much of anything here. The federal government is imposing it on us because...
Can you?
Thank you, absolutely, because we don't seem to want to do that.
I always knew that one was a conflict.
Speaking of imposing it on us, any idea what we're gonna do regarding the backflow preventers on Baldwin Street?
That'll also be part of it, and I'll be talking about that too. Partially, it's gonna be a session. Part of the, under the ACO, it's gonna be back for the center of the fact. And Lori is part of it.
If they are gonna charge you for how much water goes down the stream, what happens when it floods?
That's the whole idea, isn't it? You shouldn't have flood water in your sanitary sewer line.
Okay, 3 foot of water on Baldwin Street, how do you stop water from getting your sanitary sewer?
Well, Joe, perhaps as an engineer, you can tell them how you stop creek water from getting into a sanitary sewer.
I think theoretically, the best way to do it, they have a completely watertight sanitary sewer system that doesn't have any rainwater or creek water getting into it, which is gonna require upgrades the system to keep it a sealed system.
That's where it is.
Right.
You know, you can't rebuild around in one day.
I understand what you're saying. It's
probably going to be a 3 decade plus
challenge
to get anywhere near this.
That's why you're going to have high sewer built. What are you going to do?
Everything's going to be great. That's why we're on these orders now.
And when they build stuff with terracotta, that was the state of the art. It's like they built around with lead pipe movement.
Yeah, right.
And now it's terracotta.
It did its job for how many years?
2000. They're still using the same.
And who really thought, when I was a kid, you were going to have all this development? Who thought?
Anything else, sir? Board and adjourn, and then we have a public hearing.
Would like to think about having some sort of a weekly meeting. I'd just like to think about that idea. I'd be glad to be the stakeholder, pick a time, year. Anybody else wants to be here? So we're not a full month cycle between doing things. I was thinking of Mondays at 3 or Mondays at 7. Mondays at 7 is a really cool time because it's a council meeting 1 week, it's parking authority another week, it's the planning commission another week. It would be really cool to do it like Mondays at 7. I don't know if Lori might be able to, sometimes be there.
She has things to do. She has a lot of things to do.
I haven't seen it if you drove.
No, I was thinking maybe you and I, and if you wanted to make it so that it was during the day, maybe on Mondays at 3 or something.
Like policy, I don't know if it's public or what?
My leanings are always towards public.
Right.
Okay, frankly, I don't think a lot of people are going to show up.
Right.
I think it's going to be lucky if you and I show up, that's probably going to be an accomplishment.
Right. That is a phone call.
I think it might be a nice rhythm to get into doing that every Monday, 3 or 7 or sometime.
Yeah.
And we could look at what's going on and try and have things move another cycle forward.
Okay. So let me talk about
it. Absolutely. Okay. You're not talking about it. Put it in motion. That's what you want. You'll do it. You got to quit this talking about it.
Right.
Put it to motion on record. Now, some people like, some people don't like it. Let everybody go on the record. And you get it out of the way, one way or the other. Right. I'm sorry, Mr. Chairman.
No, that's fine.
Because he'll never be happy if you say we're going to talk about it. We're going to look about it. Everything you say, you put in motion, and you get it in or out. And then you don't talk about it anymore next month. With him, that's what you got to do. You do it, it's in.
You do it one or the other.
My God, it's so easy to resolve this situation. You have several votes over here. You like this idea to have meetings, to have another meeting. Whatever it is, put them in motion. Somebody make a motion? If nobody make a motion, it's gone. And you don't talk about it anymore. To me, that would be the logic thing to do. You could tell your kid that, oh, you're not gonna eat that candy. If you're not gonna take the candy out of the house, sooner or later he's gonna eat it.
Was that directed at me or what?
No, I think it was more directed.
It was a nice apple. It was nice. Why would I see that?
I'm gonna give a motion to adjourn and we're gonna move forward to the next meeting.
So move.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed?